أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، ليهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صفيه وحبيبه، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الأمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن سن بسنته إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها وإن كل محدثة بدعة وإن كل بدعة ضلالة وإن كل ضلالة في النار. ثم أما بعد، my dear respected brothers, children, sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We ask Allah تبارك وتعالى to accept our meeting, desiring us for knowledge from the Quran, Sunnah النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Actually, your brother, I came here Thursday and I explained the second part of Al-Hajj, which is started from Arafah and on. And we finished it together on Thursday. Is there anybody, because we have its coming days, the 10 days of the Hajjah. But if you want me to explain actually the Arafah and the Fiqh, again, to give you like a quick idea, I have no problem, inshallah ta'ala. Or we speak about the 10 days of the Hajjah. And what we can pay again in 10 days of the Hajjah, because this is also, it's very important, we need together to go through, to get collected the benefit, inshallah ta'ala. And let me speak about the 10 days first, inshallah ta'ala. الله تبارك وتعالى خلق الزمان وخلق المكان. الله سبحانه وتعالى is the one who created الزمان, it means the time, والمكان and the place. وفضل بعضه على بعض. And Allah and another one of them exceed in degrees. Right? So in degrees. That means Allah prepared some months, days over days, night over night, and even the heart over heart. What does that mean? From the time which Allah Ta'ala created, Allah made the best month ever in the whole year, the month of Ramadan. And after month of Ramadan, the month of Dhul-Hijjah. But Ramadan takes priority. Why Ramadan? The month of Al-Quran, the month of forgiveness, the month of mercy. And in Ramadan, there is the night, it is the best night ever. Allah, He created for all mankind the night of Laylat al-Qadr. خَيْرٌ مِنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. It is the best. Allah mentioned in Surah al-Qadr, it is better than 1,000 months. That means the night is better than any days, not even days. It's better than 1,000 months. And Allah تبارك وتعالى made the 10 days, the first 10 days of the month of the Hijjah to be the best days ever. Allah تبارك وتعالى created for all mankind the first 10 days of the Hijjah. قال تعالى, Allah سبحانه وتعالى says in the Quran in many many ayat to see what is the value of the 10 days of the month of Dhul Hijjah. قال تعالى, the first ayah I choose to you today, Surah Al-Fajr. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الله سيدنا القرآن. والفجر وليال عشر والشفع والوتر والليل إذا يسر. الله يسوير and he give oath about this four. And when Allah تبارك وتعالى takes some of his creatures and he swear by it or he give oath by this, that he is valuable or not valuable? Valuable. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, والفجر, Allah he give oath by the time of al-fajr. The best time ever, the time of al-fajr. When the Muslim start with up and make wudu and go for Salat al-Fajr. That is the best time Allah he give oath by the time of al-fajr. And Allah says, وَلَيَالِ الْعَشْرِ by the 10 nights. قال ابن عباس ترجمان القرآن رضي الله عنهما the 10 nights mean the first 10 days of the month of Dhul Hijjah. That is Allah also give oath by this 10 days. وَلَيَالِ الْعَشْرِ by the 10 nights. Ibn Abbas and all the Sahaba that see from the Prophet ﷺ, that mean the first 10 days of the month of the Hajj. وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ Allah is also swear by or give oath by الشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ also that means it's very valuable. And Allah is swear also by وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا يَسْرِ that means also by the night which Allah تبارك وتعالى created for all of us. الحمد لله. So this is the first ayat together. Alhamdulillah, we found from this ayat that Allah prepared these days and He gave oath. He swore Allah swear by it. The second ayah which He mentioned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned also in Surah Al-Hajj. قال تعالى سعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وأذن في الناس بالحج يأتوك رجالا وعلى كل ضامر يأتين من كل فج عميق ليشهدوا منافع لهم ويذكروا اسم الله في أيام معلومات على ما رزقهم من بهيمة الأنعام فكلوا منها وأطعموا البائس الفقير. It's beautiful ayah also from Surah Al-Hajj. Allah says in the Quran, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَا إِبْرَهِيمُ أَوْ إِبْرَهِيمُ proclaim al-hajj to mankind, to الناس. And Ibrahim was in a desert. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala nabiyyina al-Fasr wa sallam. He was in a desert. He received an order from Allah tabaraka ta'ala to proclaim, to call the people for al-hajj. And he turned his face to the right side, left side, look around him, there's nobody. Then he said, there's nobody here. Yeah, Jibreel when he came and he told him, Allah commanded you to call the people for al-hajj. He said, there's nobody going to hear me. Then Jibreel alayhi salam, he told him, just the same. Call the people for al-hajj and leave the rest for us. So when he proclaimed the hajj, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجْ call the people for al-hajj, Ibrahim climbed the mountain and he said, أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ O people, إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ فَرَضَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْحَجِّ فَحُجُّوا إِلَى بَيْتِ اللَّهِ O people, Allah command you to perform the Hajj, go and perform the Hajj for Allah تبارك وتعالى. Then the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Allah take it from his mouth and he send it to all destinations, every deep distance, all continents, town, cities, behind mountains, ocean, behind oceans. The dua, the calling for al-hajj, reach even the animals. Even if Ba'adat says, even the baby inside the womb of the mother, heard the call for azan for al-hajj. And for all of us today, we feel it too. In the time of al-hajj, you find our heart connected to where? Connected to where? To Mecca. I want to go for hajj. That's why you love al-hajj. You know it's going to cost you money, but you enjoy it. You know it's going to cost you too. It's been the time and you're going to be doctored, you're going to sleep on the floor, you're going to go for so and so, but you love it. And every time after you finish, you feel tired. But what you say after you finish the Hajj, you say, you know, inshallah, I will come again. Allah makes the love of Al-Hajj and Umrah inside our heart, so you love to go. Everybody wish to go. May Allah provide us with Al-Hajj and Umrah, inshallah, ta'ala, and accept it from the brother and sister, those who perform Al-Hajj and Umrah this year, inshallah. So Allah says in this ayah, وَأَذِّمْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ. This holy command to Ibrahim to call the people for Al-Hajj, to come to this area. For Al-Hajj. There's some people today, when you call, they believe, go for Al-Hajj. Say, oh, I'm still young. I'm still young. Will I be Shaiba? Shaiba, you know what Shaiba? I say Shaiba. When I became like an old man, I'm going to go for Al-Hajj. I'm still young. When I became 70 years, subhanAllah, I ran one of the brothers. Allah provided him too much. I know him, you see. Told me, Akhi, subhanAllah, you're 65 years old. Go for a Hajj. He said, no. I'm never going to go to Hajj. I said, why? He said, because actually I don't go to Hajj because Saudi Arabia. What's your business in Saudi Arabia? What's your business in Saudi Arabia? SubhanAllah, shaitan deceiving him. Shaitan. And another one, I meet him, one from brother from India. He told me, I don't go to Hajj. I said, why you don't go to Hajj? Because he said, the Kaaba is not supposed to be in Saudi Arabia, it's supposed to be in India. So I don't go to Saudi Arabia because the Hajj, the Saudi Arabia stole the Kaaba to make it in the Arabian and it should be in India. What is your proof? He said, because when Adam, Allah sent him down from the Jannah, he went to India and he built the Kaaba over there. The wrong direction. SubhanAllah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from the fitna and from the shaitan. وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرًا. They will come by foot. When the people hear the adhan, they will come by foot. By every lean camel. They come by the train. They come by the ship. They come by the plane. They come by donkey. People in the galaxy, they have no train, they have no ship, they have nothing. What they use? They use a camel and horses, whatever it is. And it was very hard. But they used to go to Mecca to perform Al-Hajj. وعلى كل ضامر يأتين من كل فج عم. They will come from every deep distance. From behind the mountains, from behind the ocean, from the continent, from north, from south, from east, from south, from west, from everywhere. Everybody loves to go for Al-Hajj, alhamdulillah. You love it, Allah. When I was in a haram, Sharif, and I found next to me, one brother, subhanAllah, very white, mashallah, his face, he looks like the moon, a light. So this, salam alaykum, where he come from? He called me, I came from Italy. And he had his children next to him, three boys, different age, four, five, six, and all of them, they wear the hat, alhamdulillah, and with the white jilbab, and they sit, wallahi, like diamonds. They look like diamonds. And his wife, she said, she's Italy, came from Italy too. Who made Italy from where? From Vatican. Those people are very difficult. But Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he had his own rule. So from this people, from this country, also Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala nice people to be a Muslim, alhamdulillah. They come from everywhere they come. And this is from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. I was in the Medina, and inside the masjid, I have a group, these people, they look like Mongoli. The ones exactly, there are some people, some brothers, they have like a big head, and they come from Asia, from this British Russian and this Syria. Something like this. Yes. And subhanAllah, all of them they have here and they a group of 25 people. And they make me and they start to speak the language. I don't understand. They speak English. He doesn't know how to speak English. But finally we found another brother from the same country. He translated, he told me, they asked you about where is the qabr, the grave, onto Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I said, come with me. Show them. They follow me. And I came and said, this is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and this is Abu Bakr, and this is Umar. Like, wallahi, I told them like this. What happened? Like, somebody had a remote control, and he just pressed the button, all of them that 25 crashed. Subhanallah, like, you bring it like, wallahi, when I look at them, I found all of them, and they cry hard with sound. I said, Subhanallah, they don't speak Arabic. They never see the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And look how the love of the Prophet, when they cut all the destination and they cut the ticket and to go and to ask about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. وعلى كل ضامر يأتينا من كل فج عميق ليشهدوا ملائكة عليهم. Why they go for Hajj? So they may be witness of benefits. Benefits for them. What is the benefit you give from a Hajj? Benefits in this day, in this life, and benefits in hereafter. In hereafter, the Jannah. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من حج ولم يرفث ولم يفسق رجع كيوم ولدته أمه. العمرة إلى العمرة كفارة لما بينهما والحج المبرور ليس له جزاء إلا الجنة. حديث البخاري. هو حديث هي أبو سيد. The first حديث the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said whatever before the Hajj and avoid to wrap up any connection, meeting with the woman or preparation. Number two, to avoid the disobedience such as lying, such as backbiting, such as cursing. All this is violate the Hajj. If he avoids this too, the Prophet ﷺ guarantee he will come back to his town, to his city, like his mother just to deliver him to this life. No sin. The second hadith, Al-Umrah, إلى العمرة كفارة لما بينهم. When you perform Umrah, and you next year you perform Umrah, Allah forgive the in between. والحج المبرور and the good Hajj, the excellent Hajj, الحج المبرور, a blessed Hajj from Allah تبارك وتعالى, ليس له جزاء إلا الجنة. There is no any reward for it except for الجنة. يشهد منافع لهم. They may witness things of benefit for them. وَيَذْكُرُ اسْمَ اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْلُومَةٍ. And they remember to mention the name of Allah in a fixed day or appointed day. قال ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما, appointed day here, this is the first 10 days of the Hajj. So Allah also, he swears in Surah Al-Hajj, by the 10 days of the month of the Hajj. That means the best day. And we'll see what the Prophet ﷺ said. يَشْهَدُ مَا تَعَلَى وَاذْكُرُ اسْمَ اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامٍ عَلَى مَا رَزَقَاهُ مِنْ بَهِيمَةِ الْأَنْعَامِ. Of what he provided them from all that, عَلَيْكُمْ صَوْتَدُ. The beast of cattle, Allah provided us. Not only cattle, house, children, money, wealth, property. We Allah provide us Allah. So when Allah provide you, you remember Allah and you spend it for the cause of Allah. He thank Allah to make the Qurbani. Eat from it and feed the Muslim, the poor people, the needy people, those who need actually help. The third surah we'll go through also. Allah mentioned the first 10 days of the month of Ramadan and month of the Hijjah is what? والسماء ذات البروج, سورة البروج. والسماء ذات البروج واليوم الموعود وشاهد ومشهود. Allah also, he give a word by السماء ذات البروج. He swear, Allah تبارك وتعالى swear of what? The level of the heavens and the power of the heavens. واليوم الموعود, appointed day, by the appointed day, واليوم, the day of the judgment, وشاهد ومشهود, by the witnessing day, and the witnessing day here, وشاهد, meaning the day of Al-Jum'ah, also, it's the blessed day from Allah, the best day also, in the whole year, يوم الجمعة عيد في الأرض وعيد في السماء. عيد in the land and عيد in the heaven, the day of الجمعة. وشاهد means by the witnessing day, that means the day of الجمعة. ومشهود by the witnessed day. The witnessed day here meaning يوم عرفة. So Allah تبارك وتعالى also is where by the day of عرفة and it includes the 10 days of the month of the Hijjah. Sunnah. The Prophet mentioned also about the 10 days of the month of the Hijjah. He has two hadith to start it together today. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم الحديث الذي قاله الإمام البخاري بسند صحيح عن ابن عباس رضي الله عليهما. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم قال ما من أيام أحب إلى الله العمل الصالح فيهن من هذه من الأيام العشر؟ قالوا يا رسول الله ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله؟ قال ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله إلا رجلا خرج بماله ونفسه ولم يعد من ذلك بشيء. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم also the beautiful hadith to say there is no any righteous deed, righteous deed for any Muslim to perform it better than the deed which he performed in these 10 days of the Hijjah. Meaning the salah will be more reward, the fasting will be more reward, the sadaqah will be more reward, the Quran will be more reward. You understand? Al-Ihsan will be more reward. To be dutiful to your parents. To be good with your brother and brother and sister in Islam. To be good for your name with your neighbors. To do all of that, it is the best righteous deed you ever you could perform in this day. 10 days is better than any righteous deed you perform it in another day. And the Sahaba, because the Prophet ﷺ said there is no any righteous deed will be most beloved to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala more than the righteous deed which you perform it in this day, in these 10 days. The Sahaba asked him, Ya Rasulullah, even al-jihad fi sabilillah, because al-jihad al-jihad fi sabilillah is also righteous deed. So the Sahaba said, even the righteous deed for the Muslim to perform it in these 10 days, even better than the jihad fi sabilillah, the Prophet he said, yes, even than better than the jihad fi sabilillah. Illa, he said, except. Here, exception here. Illa rajulan. Illa rajulan, except a man. Kharaja bimalihi wa nafsihi. Wa lam ya'ud bihi min dhalika bishay. Except a man who went out with his soul, his nafs, ومالك, and his wealth, and his wealth, and he went out to fight في سبيل الله, and he doesn't come back with anything. That means he died في سبيل الله, and he spent all his money في سبيل الله. This person will be actually better than the righteous deed which he performed in this 10 days. If we have somebody downstairs, please come upstairs. Somebody downstairs, come upstairs, inshallah, for the class. So, alhamdulillah, this is the first hadith. Second hadith. Hadith ibn Umar, radiallahu anhu wa ardahu. In akhrajahu al-imam Abu Dawud wa al-Tirmidhi, bisanad sahih. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ma min ayyam a'azzamu inda Allah, wa la ahabbu ila Allah, العمل الصالح فيهن من هذه من الأيام العشر فأكثروا فيها من التحميد من التسبيح والتحميد والتهليل والتكبير. It's beautiful hadith also. There is no any righteous deed. The Muslim he may perform it. The most greatest will be the most greatest and most beloved righteous deed to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala more than this 10 days of the month of the Hijjah. Meaning, the greatest righteous deeds, the most beloved righteous deeds, closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sight, this righteous deed, which the Muslim performed in this 10 days. And the Prophet, he adds something different than the first hadith. تأثروا فيها. Increase. من التسبيح. Meaning, say subhanallah. والتحميد. Meaning, say alhamdulillah. والتهليل. Meaning, say la ilaha illallah. والتكبير. Meaning, الله أكبر. That means when you say subhanallah, walhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar. So the Prophet said, increase all the tasbih and subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, allahu akbar in these 10 days. Because also the Sahaba, they used to practice it. Imam Abu Dawud, rahimahullah, he said, Ibn Umar and Abu Hurairah, radiallahu anhum ajma'in. He used to enter the market and he used to make this talbiyah and this tasbih and tahmid in the market, and the people repeat it after them. So when they enter the market, they say, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, wallahu akbar, and the people repeat after them in the market. And also they used to say talbiyah, labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik la sharika laka labbaik, إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك لبيك. They used to say this دعاء حضرة عبد الله بن عمر the son of عمر and أبو هريرة in the market, and the people in the market, buyer and seller, they used to repeat it after them. Great generation of the Sahaba. But what happened to the market today, أشخاص? So that if I say subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, I'm asking you, did this cost you too much sharab time? Muslim, if somebody is there? Nobody? Yes, bring them, both of them, inshallah ta'ala. Yeah? No, tell them, inshallah ta'ala, to come. So, subhanallah, alhamdulillah, wa la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. What about if I say that? What about if I say subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar? Look what the Prophet said. If you say subhanallah, subhanallah, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will grant for you in the Jannah a tree. An ajr, a reward equal to the mountain of Uhud. Muhammad Reed, come up upstairs, and you Mahmoud. Both of you come upstairs. Subhanallah, he will cost you, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will grant a tree in the Jannah, and a reward equal to mountain of Uhud. If you say Alhamdulillah, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will grant for you in the Jannah a tree and a reward equal to the mountain of Uhud. And if you say La ilaha illallah, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will grant for you a tree and a reward equal to the mountain of Uhud. And if you say Allahu Akbar, Allah will grant a tree for you in the Jannah and a reward, thawab, ajr, equal to the mountain of Uhud. Do you know how much that, how big the mountain of Uhud is? We don't talk about Allah will give you equal reward or thawab, equal to 1,000. We talk about a mountain of Uhud. So you need to build your garden. You need to build your garden in the hereafter. It's cost you nothing. It's cost you free. Say subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala with everything is subhanallah, alhamdulillah, la ilaha illallah, la Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, it's a tree. So you could build your garden in the Jannah. Build it by yourself. It costs you nothing. Either here in this life, If you need to build your garden, it's going to cost you a lot of money. Right? It costs you a lot of money. But this is free if you need a lot of trees and you build your garden in the hereafter. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will give you a lot of sawab. You cannot measure it at all. May Allah build it for us, inshaAllah ta'ala. So this is actually what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says clearly about it. The preferred day, this 10 days. In ajr, in tawaf, Allah uses it and he swear by this 10 days. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned it all of us, it's better than any rain. The ajr in this 10 days is better than the ajr in the other days in the whole year. Therefore, this is the ni'mah from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. We need to go, what we should do in this 10 days. What is fada'il هذه الأيام? The preferences and the benefits of this 10 days. The Prophet said, أَكْثِرُوا فِيهَا. Increase your righteous deeds in this 10 days. Salah, for example. As-salah, anybody today, everybody brings. But we don't train ourselves actually for more sawab. You don't have a chance to perform Hajj this year, right? You don't have a chance to go for Umrah this year. Can I do it without any money? If you come to any agency or travel agency and you told them I want to go free, they're never going to give it to you. You have to pay for it. But I show you the secret how you get it free. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for example, قال sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, الحديث رواه الإمام أحمد بسند صحيح عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال صلى الله عليه وسلم عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه وارضاه قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى الهداة في جماعة whoever goes to the masjid and he pray the fajr in جماعة ثم جلس يذكر الله حتى طلعت عليه الشمس فقام فصلى ركعتين كتب له من الأجر حجة وعمرة تامة The Prophet repeated it three times. What is that mean, Sheikh, in this hadith? Said to the Prophet, said, whoever go to the masjid and he pray the fajr in jama'ah, in the masjid, and after the salah he sit down, yadhkur Allah, read Al-Quran, make dua, make him dhikr, and he sit down until the sun rise. And after the sun rise, 20 minutes, half an hour, فَقَامَ فَصَلَّى رَكْعَتَيْنِ الضُّحَى أَقَلُّهُمَا رَكْعَتَيْنِ He stand up and he pray two rak'ah, call it Salat al-Duha. Duha is mean after. Allah is swear also by what Duha wal-Layl. He swear by the time of Duha. The Duha time meaning after the sun rise, 20 minutes, half an hour. And he stand up and he pray at least two rak'ah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam guarantee for you, like you have an ajr, you can have a reward, equal to Hajj and Umrah together, complete, the Prophet repeated three times. What do you think about this? See how we're losing in this our life? We're losing too much. Does it cost you money now, right? It costs you time, because I know everybody likes to pray the Fajr and run to the bed, include myself, and run to the bed and sleep. Tired, we need to sleep. But if you need to perform Hajj and Umrah, this is easy way, but this doesn't exclude you from Hajj to Islam. He said, Sheikh Mustafa, he said, every day I'm going to do it, don't go to Mecca. No, no, Yahi. We took it to Ajj. Allah will give you the reward equal to Hajj and Umrah, complete. And the riwayat Abu Dawood,
ده حديث في ابو داود واثنين
ده برافق اصلا نسيت واثنين ده حج عن عمره والبي واثنين كانوا يدور
اكثر من النوافل in this 10 days you need to pray a lot of nafila a lot of salah because as we agree the righteous deed in this 10 days is better and the Muslim beloved action for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala inshaAllah ta'ala Allah will accept it and reward you a lot more than any day so salah qira'at al-Quran read al-Quran because some people will know the Muslim only know read the Quran when? In the month of Ramadan. And by the last days, Sheikh Hassan, he finished the Quran. Alhamdulillah. So قُلَ أَعُوذُ رَبِّ الْفَلَقِ And then he finished the Quran. And then everybody says, Alhamdulillah, he finished it. Alhamdulillah. Put it in the shelf. I'll see you next year in Ramadan. That's what happened today. All of us, most of us, we do that today. So, the Quran only the people open it in the month of Ramadan, but look what the Prophet of Allah to say. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم على قناطير الفردوس. قناطير of الفردوس it means the bridges of الفردوس. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم اسألوا ربكم الفردوس الأعلى. When you pray in your dua, Ya Allah, enter me or provide me الفردوس الأعلى. This is the highest level of Al-Jannah. All the time when you pray to Allah, you are in front or you where? Al-Firdaus Al-A'la. May Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala enter all of us Al-Firdaus Al-A'la with our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But you need actually to have to guarantee Al-Firdaus Al-A'la. Here is the prescription from the Prophet. It's free as Sheikh Tom. Doesn't cost us money. But you know, to have to be honest with you, المعطية cost you money. This obedience, it cost you money. But الصلاة والتقوى is free. To be able to do righteous work, it's free, it doesn't cost you money. I show you. Disobedience to disobey Allah tabaraka ta'ala cost you money. When you want to buy the magazine with cost you money, right? Right? Cost you money. Alright? When you want to exactly watch a movie, cost you money. CD, cost you money. When you want to go to club, cost you money. When you go for fun, cost you money. Everything in this life, the shaitan is way, cost you money. But Allah is way free. Look what the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. You want to enter the highest level of Al-Jannah? جنة الفردوس قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من قرأ عشر آيات في سبيل الله وعبر بأوبن ذا قرآن and recite only 10 آيات 10 آيات في سبيل الله 10 آيات wake up young generation 10 آيات what is that gonna do for you don't concentrate لم يكتب من الغافلين. Allah will never list his name among the neglectful. Neglectful. You will never be in the list of neglectful. وكتب من القانتين. And Allah will list his name among those who are قانتين. What means قانتين? The obedience. يطيع الله ورسوله. وكتب من المقنطرين and Allah will list his name among those people who are in Qantara it means the bridge كان حقا على الله it is due Allah تبارك وتعالى to let you enter the bridge because جنة الفردوس has a bridge Allah will make this bridge easy for you to cross this bridge and when you cross this bridge in the day of the judgment, you find yourself to where? Jannat al-Firdaus. Jannat al-Firdaus. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, mention about this bridge. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم يبعث كل مسؤول يوم القيامة على قنطرة فوق جهنم. Every responsible in Islam will be sent to a bridge. A bridge. Over جهنم والعوذ بالله. Over the hellfire. فينقفض به الجثة انتفاضة. This bridge will shake him up. فتنتزع كل أعضائه. All his body will be fallen apart. All the body will be fallen apart. ثم يجمع. And Allah تبارك وتعالى will gather or build his parts again. فإن كان من المحسنين نجي بإحسانه. And if he was among the محسنين, it means the obedient, the righteous, he will be saved by this righteousness. وإن كان غير ذلك, and if he was something else, فينخرط به الجسر في النار 70 خريفة. And this bridge will be fallen on the deep of Jahannam, and he will stay 70 years in Jahannam. In the hellfire. May Allah make all of us from Jahannam. Jahannam is not easy. The hellfire is not easy. وَلْيَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ. May Allah take all of us all the time in your dua. Ya Allah, save us from the hellfire. When Allah said in the Quran, تَلْفَحُ وُجُوهَهُ مِنْ نَارِ. You know what is that meaning, Ayah? You know what is that meaning, Ayah, Sheikh Hassan? تَلْفَحُ وُجُوهَهُ مِنْ نَارِ. وُجُوه, it means the face. What is their face? You know the fish has what? Skin. When you like, you bring the fish, and you bring the fish and you put it over the fire. The skin of the fish, what's going to happen to the fish? Skin of the fish? You get but. You cook or you bake the fish and you put it over the fire, you see all this skin, it will be exploded. But all the skin. Allah mentioned that for a human also from the heat of Jahannam. If the people pass by, and only from the heat, is not from the fire. The heat of Jahannam, the skin of the human will be what? Will be what? Will be exploded, actually, like the fish when you put it in the hellfire, and a'udhu billah, in the fire or in the heat, you find the skin will be burned. May Allah save us. So, this ayat, Allah will consider you among the as-salihin, the obedient. And you will for sure even have to cross this bridge, and you find the Jannah after you enter this bridge, inshallah, and you battle. Fine. What else? You have a lot of things. If you do it in this 10 days, al-ihsan ila al-nas, to be dutiful to your parents. If you are not trained to kiss, because it's very difficult, the people feel like, you know, he's lower, he lowers himself. If he comes to take a shaykh, salamu alaykum, father, and he starts kissing. Our children today consider it like what? That's like, he lowers himself, because he has a prestige. He's in high school. He's in a college, he married, he has children. Ya Yahi, you need to learn how you respect your parents and to be dutiful. Come to your mother, come to your father, and lower yourself and kiss the head of your father. Kiss his hand, kiss the foot of your mother. Kiss the foot of your mother. Be dutiful to your parents. Your father, he worked very hard to raise you up. He doesn't deserve from you to speak with him with rough and tough. He deserves from you to be beautiful to him. You must let our children, they know, or us at home also. We need to learn how to be beautiful with our parents. Subhanallah, when your mother will die, Allah تبارك وتعالى في عليا يقول ماتت التي كنا نرحمك من أجلها تعمل صالحة نقيمك من أجله. The one who used to please you, the one who used to give you mercy, the one who used to provide you because of her, she passed away. Now go and prove yourself and work very hard, do righteous in order to deserve the mercy from us. Your parents, وَإِنْ ظَلَمَاكَ Even if your parents, they treat you unjustly. وَإِنْ ظُلَمَاتْ Even they treat you wrong. Don't ever compete. Don't ever stand against them. Because قال ابن حزم في المحلى The great Imam called it ابن حزم in a book, great book in Islam Sunnah to explain the Sunnah to النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then ban, لا يغفرهم الله. Two sins Allah never forgives. الشرك بالله and number two, وعقوا الوالدين and to disobey your parents. Never will be forgiven. You never receive any forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is two sins, be aware of it. We need to save you, we help you. Let train yourself to kiss your head every day in the morning. Assalamu alaikum, father. Abi, tell him by the Arabic language. But not that just to tell you, yo. He's not playing with you around the corner. Yo, yo. You tell your father, yo. Subhanallah, say pop, pop, pop. Subhanallah, the hawla la quwwata illa billah. Hey, pop. Not playing with you, akhi. Tell Abi, Abi in the Arabic language is mean father. Kiss his head. Kiss your mother's head. Lower yourself. You have to train yourself for how you respect your parents. Because Allah give you mercy, Allah give you health, Allah let you pass the exam, Allah give you a good wife, Allah so and so. It's upon how you treat your parents in Islam. May Allah help us inshaAllah ta'ala. If your parents are not here, pick up the phone. Well, assalamu alaikum father, assalamu alaikum mother. How are you? Every week. Every week. It's going to cost me because it's going to cost me cards. And the card is going to cost me $5. SubhanAllah, you go here around the corner and you buy a sandwich and soda and cost you more than $5. Remember this. Al-ihsanu ila al-nas. To be good with your brother in Islam. To know something, go call it al-hubbu billah. To love the person for the cause of Allah. You know our relationship is building benefits. You know your brother because how benefits you're going to get from him. You need exactly a relation built on money or business or benefits. Nobody loves his brother actually in Islam for the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the hadith and concentrate in this hadith. Very important hadith. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم الحديث أخرجه الإمام الترمذي وأبو داود وأحمد وابن حبان as a beautiful hadith authentic hadith and can't compare it with me. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم to show you how much important to have a relation with your brother in Islam and your relation with him will be for the cause of Allah, for روح الله, only for Allah. Without any looking for benefits, without any relationship between you and him, but for Allah. Look at ourselves in this small jama'ah now. Small jama'ah. And we're sitting together today. Some people came from Pakistan, some people from Uzbekistan, some people come from Bangladesh, some people come from India, some people come from Egypt, some people come from Al-So, and we came from a different area. Why are we sitting together today? Because gathering up for al-hubbu fillah. I love you for the cause of Allah. I don't need any business from you. You don't need any benefits from me. And we're sitting together because we love each other fi sabilillah. Without any looking for the benefits. I think all of you, when you come to the class, you don't look for actually any benefits or loan from each other or relationship between you each other and going because my cousin is going there. La, you come for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And you're gonna leave the masjid for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Look at the hadith. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inna min ibadi la ulatan. From among my servants, believer, there is some people. Out of this servant of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, inna ma'arif sohbat, inna min ibadi la unasan. Some people from the servant of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, inna min ibadi la unasan. Ma hum bi anbiya, wala hum bi shuhada. Allah chooses a group from His servants. They are not prophets. They are not messengers. And they are not shaheed. They are not martyrs. So, Allah describes this kind of people and contemplates to be one of them. مَا هُمْ بِأَنْبِيَاءُ وَلَا هُمْ بِالشُّهَدَاءُ. They are not Nabi, they are not Prophet, they are not Messenger, they are not Shaheed. يَغْبُطُمُ الْأَنْبِيَاءُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةُ. They will receive invade, they will be invade from who? From all the Prophet and all the Shaheed. Look at this, look at the word there. Group of the believers, Allah tabaraka ta'ala choose them from amongst the servants of Allah. They are not prophets, they are not shaheed. In the day of the judgment, all the Nabi, all the messengers, all the shaheed, they will invade them. They will be invaded by the Prophet and Hasan. Everybody gonna look at Subhanallah, who's this people? Who gonna want to be wonder? The Prophet and the Messenger and the Shaheed. When they saw this group of people, they said, we wish to be like them. The Nabi, the Shaheed, they will say, we wish to be like these people. Subhanallah. يَغْبِطُهُ الْأَنْبِيَاءُ وَالشُّهَدَاءُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. قَالُوا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ مَنْ هُمْ. The Sahaba, they didn't let it go. That's okay, what's my business, man? That's okay, this is not my business. Nah. The Sahaba weren't like that. The Sahaba, they asked, they need to be like the, among this group of people. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم قوم تحابوا بروح الله من غير قرابة بينهم ومن غير أموال يتعاطونها بينهم. Kind of people, what happened to these people? تحابوا في الله, they love each other for Allah. Without any relationship, no relationship between them. Without any money, to or trade or business among them. Without looking for benefits of trade and business or money. But they love each other في سبيل الله. يحب في الله, the best action in Islam when you choose one of your brother or group of Muslims and you love them for who? For Allah, without looking for any benefits from them. Today, your brother, he told you, Sheikh, I need your help, Sheikh Mohsen. Sheikh Mohsen told him, for sure, asking him, told him, I need something from you to find something from me, or I need $500, or I need to take me with you to your shop. And then Sheikh Mohsen would say, meet me tomorrow in the mash. He's not Mohsen, but we just give a name. And then after that he said, how much time I have to meet you tomorrow, brother? So you meet me after Isha. The brother came and prayed Isha. And he stayed actually 2 hours after the Isha. Where is Mohsen? Mohsen is here. Where is Mohsen? He met Mohsen 1 month later. And he told him, where are you, Sheikh Mohsen? I went to the masjid as we promised each other. And what happened to you? He said, Wallahi, I was very busy because I'm having a very busy schedule. See you tomorrow. It's not working. Our relation became a benefit. How many Muslims today steal his brother in Islam? And under what? And he never considered this. If you're taking money from your brother, how many people? Allah tabaraka ta'ala give us this opportunity to move to a different masajid. I think Allah, he put me in this position. To move to a different masajid to teach and give a khutbah. But I know that the disease of the community, a lot of disease. When the Muslim told them, I am very expertise. Just to give me money, I will inject it for you. The brother, he take all the faith and he give it to his brother because he trusted him. And for somehow, he spent the money, invested the money in the stock market. And when after he loses his money in the market, he comes to his brother
وكان يدوم داخل الوصول بمني
يا اخي الله ركب في الاصل بس يذكر فوق مبنتشة الله سبحانه عشاء الله والبروفايد but you take in $30,000 from me my brother يا الله قطور رأيي ان شاء الله تعالى الله والبروفايد you go
not working it's not working in Islam like this
how many people they take the money and they say in the end in the end the shaitan will let him believe
that he will I make a commission for my brother commission you steal, you are a thief. It's not commission.
This is not commission at all. So the relationship between you and your brother should be what? For Allah tabaraka ta'ala. You love your brother. You love to meet him. If you love your brother, you find your brother are not in the masjid, give him a call.
What happened? I didn't see you in the Fajr yesterday.
What happened? I didn't see you in Aisha. You almost like a week. Why are you disappear? Some among the staff, we never do know anything about them.
No, remind them, if you love your brother, you love him for the way of Allah.
You love him for the way of Allah. You meet him for Allah, and when you leave each other, you leave each other for Allah.
Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh, inshallah, I will see you in Fajr tomorrow.
So you leave to go and give yourself a rest to sleep, because you have a brother to meet him again and again again in the house of Allah. Or to stay in the class, or to go and visit some people. How many one of us? Help me, ya Sheikh. If you know somebody back the way, give me a call. Tell me there's somebody back the way. Come with me to the janazah.
You help me.
Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You need the benefit for your brother? Here is the benefit. Look at the janazah. Somebody back the way from the community. Call me and tell me there is the janazah. Send a text message.
You know text message, right? You know it very well.
Just to send the text message. Abdul Rahman, he passed away, and the funeral will be in so and so, and come with me.
You looking for the benefits for your brother.
قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى على جنازة فله أجر مثل جبل أحد.
Whoever prays صلاة الجنازة, Allah will give him أجر, reward, الثواب. Equal to the mountain Uhud. You know how much? You need 5 minutes by car to finish the mountain Uhud.
Equal to the mountain Uhud will be for in your good deeds, in your nizam, in the day of the judgment, if you break the Prophet Janan.
On behalf of it. You don't need to know him.
It's not necessity that I know.
Who's this?
Muhammad Akh. Muhammad Shaba. I never know whom. I never seen him. I don't have time.
Ya Akhi Subhanallah. For any Muslim.
It's not necessary to be your friend. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم وَمَنْ أَجْبَعَ حَتَّى تُقْبَرْ فَلَهُ مِثْلُ جَبَلِ أُحُدْ بِعَطَيْهِ
And whoever follows the janazah until he sends his brother or his sister in Islam to the janazah, Allah will give you ajr, reward, equal to the mount of Uhud twice. This is the benefit you need from me.
The class. You see anybody missing, call him. Send a text message. Tell him, have a class. What is the benefit of the class, Sheikh? قال صلى الله عليه وسلم لساعة علم خير لك من عبادة 70 قريبا.
1 hour. It's not necessary to be 60 minutes. It could be half an hour. It could be 15 minutes. It could be 1.5 hour. It could be 2 hours.
ساعة اثنين قائم. To stay in the majlis, in the meeting, to gain the Islamic knowledge, خَيْرٌ لَكَ better for you than you worship Allah 70 years. Allahu Akbar. So that means you sitting together, Allah gave me ajr and reward, or better than I worship continuously for 24 hours. Not only for 24 hours, better for you than you worship Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala 24 hours continuously every day for 70 years.
How many hours you spend you give it to Allah every day? Huh? How many hours? Sheikh Mostafa, I look up for the Fajr. And then after that, the Fajr Salah will take from you up 10 minutes. The Zohar 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, I don't complete 1 hour. 1 hour. And Allah created how many hours for the day? 24. So, he's sitting in the table to eat 2 hours. But the whole Salah, it will take like 5 minutes.
SubhanAllah, when I visit somebody, a Muslim, I visited, I went to him in Sabah in the New Jersey. He invited me, so I went to give him da'wah.
And I told him, he told me I was exactly rich within the Maghrib. I prayed alhamdulillah the Maghrib, and that only Salah was Isha.
So the brother, he invited me, and I went to him by the time of Isha. There is a Sabah, there is no masjid. He told me the masjid is 2 hours from his house. Alhamdulillah, we meet Jama'ah in his house.
Told him now the Isha, let's go pray the Isha. Together now, Jama'ah. He told me, no, Sheikh, because I have to pray Zuhri first. Say what? You want to pray what? Told me, pray the Zuhri. Told me, Subhanallah, you didn't pray the Zuhri. What about the Asr? He told me, I did not pray the Asr. So Subhanallah, how about the Maghrib? He told me, I did not pray the Maghrib. So Subhanallah, so you don't pray the Zuhri. And he said, Alhamdulillah, Sheikh, before I leave in the morning, I pray Salat al-Subh. And the Zuhr and Asr and Maghrib, and when I come back in the night time with the Isha, I pray the full Salah. Alhamdulillah. I pray Qadha. You pray Qadha. Full Salah. You need the Zuhr in the Isha time. It's Qadha, ya akhi. Qadha. The man Sheikh, my Imam, he told me, it's okay to pray Qadha. Qadha. What about the Surah al-Ma'ud? وَيْلٌ لِلْمُصَلِّينَ الَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنْ صَلَاتِهِمْ سَاهُونَ. Wail, Umar radiallahu anhu arba, he said, wail, it is the valley in the middle of Jahannam. Very very for the who? For those who pray. But those who pray what? Who was born in the Salah? Prefer the match. The match can first the before man, you're gonna miss it. The game, the movie. Movie come first. Do not time, was born in the Salah, was born in the Salah. Watching the game. Salat al-Maghrib now is 5 o'clock. He was born in the Asr until 4. 3:30, still early. 4 o'clock, still early. 4:15, still early. 4:30, still early. 4:45, still early. 4:50, astaghfirullah, I didn't raise up. Go and make wudu for 1 second. Come back, Allah, finish. Alhamdulillah, I bring the out. 5 minutes before the Maghrib, he brings out. Not working. So the brother, I sit in the side, okay, inshallah, go and pray, but don't do it again. He will. He prayed both. And up. And Maghrib, 3 salat. I looked at the watch. It took 10 minutes to pray the Dhuhr and Asr and Maghrib. Because we have something called salat in our generation. We are in the generation of the computer. Computerized. Fast man, we don't have time. I'm not going to stay like an hour to pray. Subhanallah. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Salat al-Dhuhr, the Sahaba, they used to come to the masjid. They found the Prophet in Salat al-Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Salat al-Dhuhr. They say, we went to Baqiyah. It's like almost half a mile behind the masjid in Medina. They went to the bathroom and wudu, and they come back again, and they found the Prophet is still in the first rak'ah. In the masjid. But our Salah today, finish, because we are in the generation of the computers. So these people, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, you love your brother for the cause of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, and then after that, look what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says. قَالَ وَاللَّهِ وُجُوهُهُمْ مِن نُورٍ. Their wujuh, their faces are nur, light. وَإِنَّهُمْ عَلَى نُورٍ. And then they are on the state of nur, in a state of light. They are guided. لا يخافون كما يخاف الناس يوم القيامة. They will never afraid like the others. Other of the people in the day of the judgment. Afraid. الأنبياء will afraid in the day of the judgment. What about you and me? الأنبياء will shaking in the day of the judgment in front of Allah. الأنبياء. What about you and me? What we gonna do? We are not Nabi. We are not Shaheed. We are not nothing. We are nothing. We are nothing. We are busy. We came to the green land. It's okay to be rich. But don't ever forget Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. So they are, their faith are full light. And they are in nur. They are guided by nur. Al-Quran,
sunnah, of salah, purification, wudu, everything, they are in light. لا يخافون كما يخاف الناس. They will never afraid like the other people in the day of judgment. And they will, ولا يفزعون كما يفزع الناس. And they will never be trembling and shaken as the other people in the day of judgment, when the people will be shaking and will be in turmoil. ثم قرأ رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ربنا صلى الله عليه وسلم أن يطلب الصحابة أو الآية ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. أولياء الله, the friends of Allah, you don't fear about them and they are not a state of grief, they don't scare, they don't afraid. لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. In the day of the judgment they will be saved. They will be under the shield of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. They will be under the security of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And they that day remember 50,000 years. And you stand in the front of Allah and the sun is 1 foot. 1 foot. Could you imagine this day? And Muhammad in the front of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And that day 50,000, like 50,000 years. One day, the yawmu yawmu al-qiyamah, it's equal 50,000 years. And he stands in the front of Allah. Until the kafir, what the kafir do? Ya Allah, send me to Jahannam, because I cannot stand anymore. He thought Jahannam is much easier. He thought Jahannam is much easier more than this standing. May Allah save us, inshaAllah, and to enter the Jannah without any judgment, inshaAllah ta'ala, without any count. But this is, inshaAllah ta'ala, what we need, inshaAllah ta'ala, to increase our deeds, inshaAllah ta'ala, in the day of the judgment. And remember, this is a good benefit for the Muslim. You need to build your treasury with Allah ta'ala, because in that day, you need it. In the day of the judgment, you need it. 10 days of the month of Dhul Hijjah, increase your work, increase your salah and nafila. Read the Quran. Fast. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, حديث أم سلمة, أم سلمة رضي الله عنها عند خالد, خالد, هنيدة ابن خالد. He said the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to fast 9 days of the month, of the first 10 days, that the first 9 days of the month of Dhul Hijjah. And he used to fast Monday and Thursday. And he used to fast 13 and 14 and 15 from every Arabic month. And when they asked him, O Messenger of Allah, why you fast Monday? He said, هذا يوم قد ولدت فيه. That day I was born. The Prophet born in Monday. And when they asked him about Thursday, he said, هذا يوم ترفع فيه الأعمال إلى الله. وأحب أن يرفع عملي وأنا قائم. And another hadith, Monday and Thursday, or the collection of the week, of the deeds which you performed, or you committed, will be raised to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala on Thursday. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I fast the Thursday, and when I love that Allah to accept my deed while I'm fasting, because the fasting will, you have your righteous deeds will be accepted right away. Fast. Fast the day. يوم عرفة خير يوم طلعت عليه الشمس. The best day ever. The sunrise. يوم عرفة. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم احتسب عند الله. احتسب عند الله أن يغفر سنتين. I seek Allah تبارك وتعالى sufficient to forgive 2 years. You fast the day of عرفة. That 1 year before and 1 year is coming. Allah forgive you for 2 years. The day of Arafa. Because that is the day يوم مشهود. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم قال صلى الله عليه وسلم يجمع الله عز وجل الملائكة في صعيد واحد. Allah gather all the ملائكة together in the day of Arafa. And he said, قال اشهدوا يا ملائكة إن عبادي آتوا شعثا غبرا. My servants come to me for Hajj and Umrah. شعثا with full dust, very tired. They came to me in the day of Arafah. be witness my angel, لقد غفرت ذنوبهم وقبلت حجتهم وغفرت وكتبت لهم الجنة. أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, be witness my angel that I forgive all the sins, I raise their degrees, and then after that they will have the Jannah, nothing more than the Jannah, inshaAllah ta'ala. So the Jannah will be يوم عرفة, it is the great day in history. Read Al Quran, Yaqi. Make fast that day and make salah, different salah, all the salah should be in jama'ah. Increase your deed, because that is the best day ever Allah Ta'ala created for all mankind. Yawm Arafa, Yawm Mashhud. And we remember also in this 10 days, Al-Amal Al-Salih, Qurbani. Qurbani. Remember to slaughter the animals. Allah Ta'ala give you a lot. Give you health, give you children, give you wife, give you health, give you everything, give you tranquility. You wake up in the morning, you find yourself, Alhamdulillah, I'm very strong, I'm healthy, Alhamdulillah. Every day in the morning, I look to my children are okay. I look to my wife, she's okay. I look to myself, Alhamdulillah, and I'm very active, and I go and make money, and I eat, and healthy, and no disease, and nothing. You have to thank Allah Tabaraka Ta'ala for that. And number two, you have to thank Allah Tabaraka Ta'ala because Allah made you Muslim. Every single moment in your life, you thank Allah, says, Alhamdulillah, because He made me Muslim. He made me Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that day, dabaha, kabshayni, amlahayni, akranayni, rashahuna ila al-qibla, wa qala, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, هذا عني وعن أهل بيتي وعن كل المسلمين. When he slaughtered and he killed two goats or two lambs, he turned, he took them, two lambs or two goats, the Prophet ﷺ, by his honored hand, he made the Qurban, he killed the two goats or two animals, after he turned them to the Kaaba, to the Qibla, and he said, this is for me, and my family member, and every single Muslim from my Ummah. So he slaughtered the animal for you. He never been selfish for himself. He remember the Ummah. He remember every single Muslim. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And what did he say when he slaughtered the animal before he slaughtered the animal? Huh? What did he say? قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Say, my salah is for who? For Allah Tabaraka Ta'ala. نُسُكِي. نسكي, نسكي اثنين يور قربان يور ذبيحة. ومحيايا all your life. ومماتي your death. For Allah تبارك وتعالى. وبذلك أمرت, لا شريك له. No partners, no associate partner of Allah. وبذلك أمرت, I have been commanded to be in this state of the faith. وما أنا من المشركين, I'm not one of the مشركين, ولا أعوذ بالله. And he said, بسم الله الله أكبر. And he killed the animal. Halal. Eat the halal, halal food. Huh? Burger King and McDonald's. Delicious. Very nice hamburger. But I don't know what that means, ya Sheikh. They are Christian. Subhanallah. But wallahi, we don't know how much they mix. Maybe they mix the pork. They never gonna tell you. Because everybody eats everything here. Everything they eat is. They made an article 5 years ago, they said they add why hamburger from McDonald's are so delicious. Why so delicious, the Sheikh? Because they add percentage of meat of kangaroo. You know the kangaroo? Yeah. The animal which has a short hand and long and very thick tail. How do you call it? Kangaroo. They add this meat. That's why they make it very soft, brother. They make it very soft and delicious. They are different. You never know what they bought. Huh? KFC. KFC. What you eat? Chinese food. Alhamdulillah. Halal is a Chinese food. Halal is a Chinese food. Alhamdulillah. 4th Avenue and 5th Avenue and so on. But our kids around the corner, they eat from the Chinese food. To be honest with you, they eat it. And you ask them, I eat the vegetable. MashaAllah, you eat the vegetable. So you eat the vegetable from the Chinese. What they make it? They made it where?
for even permission. They know that Chinese, they love dog and cat. They love dog and cat. Wallahi, I told them in the TV, they cook dog and cat, the best food, because they have, they are cat, mushrik. They eat everything. They eat everything. So and they also, they love pork. So this bob, you eat vegetables. They say the same bob, they cook the endeer, they cook the cat, they cook the dog. Be a Muslim, be Muslim and clear.
Hebrew national, hato. Hebrew national. I find Hebrew national a shit.
It's a kosher, subhanAllah. You ask it, subhanAllah. You eat that, you trust to them in kosher. But anyway, I need you to examine. Take a bit of meat from halal around the corner. Bit of meat, one down. And give it to Yahudi. This is halal meat. Eat it. You gonna eat it?
No.
What you eat then? What you eat, Yahi? What you eat? Hebrew national. You're not gonna lie because of the hot dog. Even the name doesn't accept it. Hot dog. Subhanallah, ya akhi, la hawla la quwwata illa billah. Be Muslim and live for halal and live by halal and fear Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Qala sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al halal bayyin wal haram bayyin wa baynahuma umur mushtabihat.
Al halal is showing clearly.
Wal haram is showing clearly. And between the halal and haram, there is a doubt. Mushtabihat. لا يعلمهن كثير من الناس.
Most of the people, they have no idea about it. Between the halal and haram. فاتقوا الشبهات. Fear Allah in the doubt. Don't eat it.
فمن وقع في الشبهات فقد وقع في الحرام. And whoever fell in the doubt, and because this is the doubt,
chicken from the supermarket, halal, chicken from the... Yahi, why you cost yourself to take the food, chicken from the supermarket? There is 100 people, they're selling chicken halal here.
What you undoubt? They put all the chicken, they bought it, they hang it.
And one soul, sometimes they kill the chicken from half, from the bottom, from the half. Sometimes from the leg.
Because the chicken anyway, they, it became like, you know, the head of the chicken, it fall down. Sometime when the chicken hear the soul to cut it, it shrunk it. When it shrunk it, come to the body, come to the shoulder, and then in the end, they're gonna give it to you. It's halal too. They're gonna give it to you as a halal.
Fear Allah tabaraka ta'ala and don't eat. Because alhamdulillah, when you came to this country, Sheikh, it was difficult. We used to travel 2 hours to buy halal meat. Where is the halal meat now today? Every corner? Of the corner? Your brother in Islam and halal meat, they suffer. They suffer.
They don't have a good business, but the Yahud, they have a lot of business because every Yahudi has to go for his own people to buy the meat from them. Go buy from your brother. Invest your money with them. Let them have successful trade and buy the halal meat from them. Because they need also to survive.
They ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept it.
They, of Arafah, Qurbani, slaughter your Qurbani. Remember the needy people. The people, they are hungry. Next, send your money to your country. Tell them, I need to slaughter a Qurbani. If you are not able, actually, there is a lot of Muslim here, masajid, all the masajid collect the money to slaughter Qurbani, to feed the needy people, inshaAllah ta'ala. Qurbani are sunnat abikum Ibrahim, sunnat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Make the Qurbani, Allah will increase you. Allah will save you in your health. Allah will provide you. Allah will bless you in your wife. Allah will bless you with your children. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you from the others. Allah will make you in a state of purification. Tuhara. That is inshaAllah ta'ala. And some more and more and more, if we stay here until tomorrow morning, the class is not enough. We need to increase and increase. Do your best in this 10 days. Come inshaAllah. I believe the moon sighting will be happening 16 or 17. I believe 16 of this month or 17. InshaAllah, happen, could that will happen, could take the message to see a moon sighting of the month of the Hijjah. Be with them inshaAllah ta'ala and be ready inshaAllah ta'ala for the first 10 days of the month of the Hijjah. Increase, because that is the greatest righteous work you may perform it to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us, inshaAllah. If you are fast, fast this 9 days. If you are not able, fast inshaAllah Monday and the third day. If you are not able, at least fast the day of what? Arafah. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive all your sins, inshaAllah, for 2 years. 1 year before, and 1 year is coming. And what's better than that? Allah, He wants you to be in the highest level of Al-Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and remember, your brother and sister, those who are standing in Arafah to perform the Hajj, they are there, are in Hajj. The main day of Al-Hajj is the day of Arafah. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to gather the Ummah for the moon fighting, because I don't find any excuse for the Muslim Ummah. More people assess like that, oh, I'm not going to go with Saudi Arabia. And the people said, tomorrow is Arafah, ya akhi. He said, no, this is not my Arafah. It hurt me when I was in Coney Island and I stopped by to buy a cup of coffee, and I entered, I found a Muslim boy in the counter and I told him, give me one coffee. Tomorrow's Arafah, inshallah, I remind him. He said, this is not my day. I said, who told you that? He said, my mother. He told me, no, your Arafah is after tomorrow. So the people are standing in Arafah tomorrow, and you are for what? For who? Egypt? Morocco? Pakistan, Bangladesh, la yaqi, all the unity of the Muslim in the day of Arafah, they is accepted, all of them, they are in the mountain of Arafah, and you are fasting here. Don't say, I'm not going to go to Saudi Arabia, but subhanAllah, when you go for Hajj, you go with who? Yeah, tell me, Hashif, when you go for Hajj, you're going to go with who? You're going to go with Pakistan, you're going to go with Egypt, or you're going to go to Saudi Arabia, and when you come back, no, hey, astaghfirullah, I'm not going to go with the Wahhabi. SubhanAllah, what's Wahhabi here, or Wahhabi? People are there for Hajj. Go with the Jama'ah. That is the basic. Everything in Islam is Jama'ah. Allah tabaraka ta'ala command us to be in the Jama'ah. Jum'ah is the Jama'ah. Eid Adha is the Jama'ah. Eid al-Fitr is the Jama'ah. Yawm Arafah is the Jama'ah. Salah is the Jama'ah. Fasting in Ramadan is the Jama'ah. Everything is for the Jama'ah. Muslims should be in one unity. Unity, united, to be put together. I don't go because of Saudi Arabia or Pakistan. I'm going with the Jama'ah of the Muslims. So when you hear they told you and deceive you, no, Arafah is not tomorrow, this is not different calendar, don't listen to them. Go with the Jama'ah, because if you miss the Jama'ah, الغنب القاطية لا يأكلها إلا الذئب. The wild animal, all the time, hide behind the cornfield, waiting for what? If the group of sheep come, never touch it. But they waiting for what? Single what? Single goat, single lamb. When he found the single goat or lamb, single, he jump and eat it, and that is actually, you be out of the Jama'ah, you cannot at all. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, لا تجتمع أمتي على راضي. When you see the old Ummah united, you never think they are in false hood, they are in truth. Because the Ummah gathered together, they Arafah together, you don't say, Saudi Arabia play with the calendar, yaqi, this is not your business, be with the Jama'ah. That's it. They describe that day, be with the Jama'ah. Because I asked the man, who told you? He told me my mother. So he was the people who will be in Arafah tomorrow. He said, I don't care. So he will celebrate Arafah when the people left Arafah. So there's nobody in the mountain today. Why you celebrate? Why you fast? He said, because my people, they told me today is Arafah, not yesterday. I'm not going to go with these people. Ya akhi, subhanAllah. And why second, you put yourself in a trouble in Tikr? Because people, the second day after Arafah is the day for Eid. The brother considers the day of Eid is his Arafah day. That means he fasts what? Haram day. Haram to fast the day of Eid. Haram to fast the day of Eid. Muslims, they need to be free. Alhamdulillah, most of us, we are free by education. Allah gave us education and we became more knowledgeable. It's different than Ya Sheikh, my grandmother, grandmother and the grandfather, they don't have education too much. Don't follow their tradition because they know nothing. You have to be educated, inshaAllah ta'ala, Allah tabaraka ta'ala, to help us when it works. I don't want to make it more than that. It's nice, alhamdulillah.
before I became a very heavy gift. So I have to be light gift, inshallah ta'ala, and to be actually to give you to eight stuff with this, inshallah ta'ala. Ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to accept it from all of us. Allahumma akfir al-mu'mineen wa al-mu'minat, nahya'u minuhu al-amwat, al-muslimin wa al-muslimat, nahya'u minuhu al-amwat. حصنا بعينك لك لا تنام ولا تكفل اجعلنا للمتقين إماما اللهم لا تجعل بيننا ولا فينا شقيا ولا رحوما اغفر لنا بالأعمال الصالحات أعمالنا وتوفنا مسلمين وارحمنا بالصالحين غير خزايا ولا مفتونين اللهم اهد أولاد المسلمين وشيوخ المسلمين ونساء المسلمين اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم يا رب اشفنا واشف مرضى المسلمين اللهم اشفنا واشف مرضى المسلمين اللهم تقبل من حجاج بيتك الكريم تقبل منهم الحج والعمره يا رب العالمين اللهم ارزقنا حجه وعمره في الطريق اللهم ارزقنا حجه وعمره في الطريق اللهم انصر الاسلام يا رب العالمين في كل مكان اللهم احفظنا بعهدك لا تنام ولا تكفل واجعلنا للمتقين اماما واجعل ثارنا على من ظلمنا وانصرنا على من عادانا اللهم اعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك واجعلنا من عتقائك من النار وقنا عذاب القبر وقنا عذاب النار وقنا الجنه مع الابرار وتب علينا يا ارحم الراحمين واهدي اولادنا يا رب العالمين اللهم اهديهم الى الايمان والعمل الصالح اللهم انا نستودعك اياهم يا رب العالمين فاحفظهم بعينك التي لا تنام ولا تكفل وارحمنا برحمه من عندك يا ارحم الراحمين واخر دعوانا ان الحمد لله رب العالمين سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك اشهد ان لا اله الا انت نستغفرك ونتوب اليك والسلام